Hello, this is Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Bregman of the Jewish Executive Learning Network, and I'm in the sukkah in Lakewood. I just want to share with you a quick video to give you some insight, some Divrei Torah into Hoshana Rabbah. Hoshana Rabbah is the seventh day of Sukkot. Very, very important day. Now, a lot of people know it's an important day, an important holiday, but they're not necessarily sure what it's about. Now, obviously, it's the last day of Sukkot. It's a little bit mysterious because even though it's not a Yom Tov, it's not an actual day of Yom Tov of Chag, it has a lot of the prayers that pertain to the Chag, that we would say only on a Yom Tov or Shabbos. So what's this day about? So first of all, why is it even called Hoshana Rabbah? Hoshana is the willow branches, which is actually one of the four Arba Minim. Rabbah means great or big. Well, what's so great about it? So the simplest explanation is that in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, in the time of the Holy Temple, the Kohanim, my brothers, my tribe, the Shevet Levi, the Kohanim, every day of the holiday, the Mizbeach, the altar in the Beis HaMikdash, had these Hoshanas, these willow branches placed on it, and the Kohanim would go around it one time, but on Hoshana Rabbah they would go around it seven times. So Hoshana Barabbah, it's a lot on Hoshana Rabbah. But more than that, where's some of the depth in the name of the holiday? So I'll tell you a bunch of quick insights. There's a medrash that says that Hashem told Avram Avinu, I am a yachid, I am unique, there's no one like me, so to speak, in the creation, and there's nobody like you, Avraham. You're a yachid and I'm a yachid. We're both unique. So since you're unique and there's no one like you, I'm going to give you a day in the Jewish calendar that's unique just for you, and that's going to be Hoshana Rabbah. So what's the connection? Avram Avinu, Hoshana Rabbah. What's the connection? So some suggest that just as Avram Avinu lived in the 21st generation from creation, so too Hoshana Rabbah comes and is the 21st day of Tishrei. Avram is in the 21st generation. So that's a little Avram, a little Hoshana Rabbah. That's one explanation. There's another pshat that says Hoshana Rabbah is special because according to most accounts, the Ushpizin, the special leader of the guests who come into our sukkah on Hoshana Rabbah is David HaMelech. And the mystical Sfarim suggests that on Hoshana Rabbah, there's a special koyach, a special power in that day to usher in the Malchus Beis David, the kingdom and kingship of King David again, which has to do with Mashiach and the future Beis HaMikdash. So there's another connection, Hoshana Rabbah, David HaMelech, Mashiach. That's part of the Torah of the day. If you would ask me, what would I like you to feel and to work on feeling in your hergeshim and your emotions on Hoshana Rabbah, I would tell you this one, and this is very, very important. On Hoshana Rabbah, a Jew is supposed to feel that the barriers between you and a Kaddish Baruch Hu have completely come down. That's really what happens on Hoshana Rabbah when we observe this very great day. Where do I find this? You find this in a Medrash in the Yalkut Shemaini. The Medrash in the Yalkut Shemaini is in Tehillim, under Kapitel Chaf Vav. The Medrash says as follows. The Medrash says something very simple. The Medrash tells us that there's a connection between the seven times we go around the Mizbeach in the Beis HaMikdash, the altar, or around the table in the Beis HaKnesses, in the Shul, and Yerichai. What happened? If you know the story, when the Jewish people first came into Eretz Yisrael in the time of Yehoshua, every single day for 6 days, the Kohanim, what do? They went around the city of Yerichai every single day. They went around it one time for 6 days, and on the seventh day, the wall of Yerichai fell down and crumbled into the ground. That happened on the seventh day. Seventh day, they went around seven times, the wall crumbled. And so too, on Hoshana Rabbah, says the Medrash in the Yalkut Shemaini and Tehillim, what happens? We go around the Mizbeach seven times, and then what happens? And what happens is that any barriers that are still remaining between us and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, from our Chatoyim, from our sins, remaining from Rosh Hashanah and Seres Yimei Tshuva and Yom Kippur, on Hoshana Rabbah, any barriers that would distance us between us and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they too crumble to the ground, any remaining traces of sin. So the day of Hoshana Rabbah is a special day to feel closeness to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's something to focus in on. One last piece. There's an Isaiah in Shir HaShirim, based on a verse in Perek Beis in chapter 2, that says something that's very interesting. If you know, the minimum number of walls of the sukkah is about 2 and change, 2 and a little bit more. You need to, now many people have 4 walls in the sukkah, but the basic minimum requirement in Jewish law is 1 complete wall and another complete wall, and let's say a half, another piece coming out, let's say 2.5. And that's a basic requirement. The Zohar speaks about what I'm about to say, and I'm going to share with you the first Mashgiach of Lakewood, Rav Nosson Vachsvogel Zatzal. He spoke about this a lot, that the Zohar speaks at this idea that image of the sukkah in its smallest amount is supposed to represent Hashem's love for us. How so? So I'll try to get this correctly on film, but let's say I would have one of my children with me and I'd put my arm around them. What would happen? So this arm over here represents one wall of the sukkah, complete wall. This wall represents another, and this piece jutting out is my hand around. So when you're in the sukkah, and especially on the last day in Hoshana Rabbah, you should try to feel the closeness of HaKadosh Baruch Hu on this day, and understand that if you did the Aseret Yemei Tshuva and Elul and Roshana and Yom Kippur and everything right up to now, you could really, really feel the closeness of Hashem. Anyway, I hope that gave you some nice insight into what the holiday of Hoshana Rabbah is about. This is Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Bregman, the Jewish Executive Learning Network. I hope you'll follow these classes on TorahAnytime.com and also check out my brand new channel on YouTube. We're having some exclusive, unbelievable content over there you will not be able to find in any other platform. Enjoy the rest of your holiday season.